I'm moving to the country, I'm gonna eat me a lot of peaches. I'm moving to the country, I'm gonna eat a lot of peaches.
Hello, welcome to the Bone Zone Podcast with Brennan Walsh and Randy Licky, and the new addition to the Bone Zone Podcast, Melissa Villasenor, me. Because you know I should be the third addition. You can please download and listen at allthingscomedy.com, which you're probably on right now. And, oh, great news. Brennan Walsh is going to be performing at the San Francisco Punchline Comedy Club November 14th through 16th. You should go see him. He's really funny and a really good pal of mine. Right, Brennan? Brennan.
What are you doing?
I was just...
Randy.
What?
Come in here. Melissa's messing with your stuff.
No. I thought it'd be nice if I did the intro for the podcast.
I thought we
podcast.
Told you not to touch the podcast.
How are you? You're using my computer. What are you doing?
Well, no, because I thought it'd be sweet of me to set it up and, you know, three of us have a great podcast.
You crossed the
today.
Line.
What did you say? Brendan's going to be where?
The San Francisco Punchline.
Oh.
Comedy
when?
Club. November 14th or 16th. I saw don't your schedule.
Don't be telling
real?
Everybody my business.
You just went through
no,
his website and found that?
I
would
did.
You go through my Google calendar?
I thought that was really kind of me.
I don't like it when people touch my friend's stuff and then start spreading rumors about me
Thank
all
you,
over
Brendan,
the internet.
I appreciate that. Well, if you're going to tell them that I'm going to be somewhere too. Just make it up. I don't care.
Randy Licky is going to be at Vaughn's.
At Vaughn's.
The Saturday.
Aren't you going to be in San Francisco? Or
I'll be there tomorrow.
Wednesday.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, well, that doesn't mean anything to people.
I'm going to post this episode right away. And then if you listen to it right away, Wednesday, October 16th, I'll be at Cobb's in San Francisco.
Ooh, and then almost exactly 1 month later, I'll be at the Punchline
yeah.
in San Francisco, the 14th through the 16th. Also,
you could
November 1st and 2nd, I'll be in Toronto for the Toronto Dark Comedy Festival. Possibly one of the last comedy festivals I will ever perform at. Everybody has a comedy festival.
And if you want to see my tour schedule, it's on melissaviasenor.com.
How does somebody spell a cockamamie name like that?
All right. I'll spell it out for them then. Get a paper pen. My last name is V as in Victor.
How do you spell Melissa?
M-E-L-I-S-S-A. Space.
M-E-A-L-I-S-A.
M-E-L.
Melissa, it sounds
M-E-L-I-S-S-A.
More like.
M-E-L-I-S-S-A. Hey. I eat peaches every day. Sun soaking. When I kiss a guy that have cigarette, that smokes cigarette, oh, it's the fucking hottest.
You probably kiss a lot of cigarette smoking guys.
No, I don't. It was just one summer fling, and it was the best thing in the world.
Did you like how it tastes, too, or just
mm-hmm.
how it smells?
Both.
When you were a little girl practicing kissing, were you practicing kissing on a pack of cigarettes?
I remember when I was a kid, and the first girl I made out with, she smoked cigarettes.
So was that hot?
I was like 13 probably or something.
How old was she?
I think she was like my age but a little bit older.
She
or I don't know, maybe
cigarettes?
14 or something. Yeah. I grew up in a rough and tumble neighborhood.
Where in Austin?
Philadelphia.
Yeah.
And
yeah. Sure.
I remember thinking it tasted like hard pretzels.
The style of kiss?
It just, no, the taste
of
like
cigarette
her cigarette mouth was like, I was like, oh, it kind of tastes like hard pretzels.
That's hot.
Randy's totally DTF, so if your friend wants to, so wait, your friend's
no,
going to come
Randy
over and bang
girlfriend.
Us on the air?
No.
I'm
told
DTF.
You no, yeah. You have a girlfriend.
No, what does DTF stand for?
It sounds down to, it sounds down, it means down to fuck.
Oh, I thought it was meant something else.
What? Well, then what did you think? Don't trip fire?
No, I thought it meant...
Don't throw fire?
Downtown Fresno.
Randy's totally DTF.
I ran for mayor in Fresno. That's why I thought you meant that.
When was that? Like 3 years ago?
3 years ago, yeah. I lost.
Do you guys have a
I was
song?
On the ballot.
I think Melissa's microphone's hot.
It's No, it's not.
It's
I don't
loud.
Think it's hot on mine.
Brennan, say hello.
It's not hot enough.
Hello.
Melissa, say hello.
Hello.
Brennan was louder.
What?
Brennan, say hello.
So my ears are lying?
Melissa, say hello.
Hello.
Those are the same.
She just sounds better. She's been taking vocal lessons?
Yeah.
Yeah.
From your boyfriend, Hootie?
Hootie is hot.
Do you still hang out with that guy?
It's still going on.
Still ongoing?
Yeah.
Unprotected anal sex every night?
It's yep. in the anus. You don't need to protect it.
Yeah.
God's protecting you at that point.
And you're saving your virginity for the right guy.
Yeah.
Technically, you're still a virgin.
Oh, no. Not even close.
Whoa. Oh, Melissa VPs.
Yeah. Melissa DP.
Yeah.
It's true.
Wait, DP?
Yeah.
Double really? Penetration?
Yeah.
What?
Oh, no. 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 That's gross.
What do you think DP stand for? Downtown Fresno?
I just thought you were
P-H-R-E-S-N-O.
Melissa, it's good to have you back.
Good to be here. Thank you so much. I knew you guys missed me.
So we got to get you out of here before our real guest gets here.
No, that's just a joke again.
Minutes.
I know you're joking around again that you have... You always say, oh, we had another guest. We didn't want Melissa. This show is just our backup. That's just a joke now, and I get it.
If we always say it, that doesn't mean it's a joke. That just means that we always say it.
Yeah, it just means that we're driving our point home.
No, it means that you two are both on the same page of being good comedic characters, while I am left in the dust every time.
No, no, no. But maybe we should do the intro for the real podcast we're going to do.
Oh, for...
For Rory,
because Rory's gonna. Yeah. So we should do the intro right now.
Yeah.
All right. Let me just pick a song.
Something like really rockin'.
Ooh.
Like, what's that?
Rockin'
the boogie
Rory.
Woogie flu got the something in
it's
the boogie,
boogie woogie. Boogie woogie woogie
bugle
man. Bugle boy.
Boogie woogie
no.
flu.
Yeah, bugle I got boy. The something.
Rockin' pneumonia.
Yeah, rockin' pneumonia and the boogie woogie flu.
All right. Who do you think that's by?
Is it Ted Nugent or is it like
it's by
Billy
a lot
Squire
of people
or?
Right now? Huey Piano Smith is
nah,
the number one that pops
be
up.
That one.
It's also by Johnny Rivers.
That might be it.
Yeah, that's a pretty good one. All right, so we're gonna mute the mics and then we'll just do.
Yeah, we'll just do the intro. This guy's got the rockin' pneumonia and the boogie woogie flu.
I always thought it was the boogie woogie blues.
No, huh? No, the guy's ill with good things though.
Pneumonia and blues aren't related.
Actually,
yeah. I thought it was
get the blues if you have
pneumonia.
I just always thought it was the blues.
So, welcome to another episode of the Bone Zone. You're in for a treat tonight. We have comedian and actor. Rory Scovel, you may know him from his multiple Conan appearances, and he's also one of the stars of a new show on TBS.
Mm-hmm, called Ground Floor.
Called Ground Floor. So he'll be with us today to talk about comedy and what it's like to make it in Hollywood, his time growing up in the South, and and getting on television.
Hey, Rory's here now.
Me and the Rand Man are going to interview him.
Yeah, so enjoy that episode.
Enjoy the new episode of the Bone Zone coming up next with old Rory Scovel, established comedian.
That's good to get that out of the way.
Yeah. Usually we record the intros after we record the episode, but
okay.
Rory's on a tight schedule, so.
Yeah, he's somewhat of a celebrity.
Yeah.
And gotta get to the next thing. Get to the next thing, you know.
Always doing stuff. What have you been up to?
Hey, this is Rory.
Randy.
Oh.
This is Rory.
Had work today. Busy day. Busy
oh,
day
yeah?
at work.
Any annoying customers coming?
Oh, Lord.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm
the lady
know,
with the shitty kids who eat candy.
That's like that just defines a lot of the kids. No, you know what? I found that I'm to a point where if someone's like a good, you can tell they're a good person and they're just being legit and real. I'm not like, oh fuck this. You know how like some people are just like, oh fuck whoever comes in the next door, fuck them.
If they're a customer, they're an asshole.
Yeah, yeah. But I do find myself kind of being like, nope, all right, I give up on this person. I'll still be pretty good, but people like to be like, a lady came in yesterday, worst person ever met.
Really? What'd she do?
Well, she came in, she walked right by me. I said, hi, how are you? She said, fine, but she didn't stop. She just walked directly because she knew where she was going. Uh-huh. And then she got to an area of the store where I couldn't see where she was. And she goes, where is sir? And I was like, what? I don't know what you're talking about. And I guess we have a cologne called sir.
Okay.
But we have like 30 types of cologne.
Yeah.
So I was like, what? And she goes, I'm sick and I need to get out of here. Help me find this. And I walked over there and I go, what are you looking for? And she goes, sir. And I like slid it into her. I was like, here it is. And then she goes, well, you don't have any testers? And I was like, it's right next to it. And then she like sprayed it and smelled it and left.
Ugh.
It's just like very rude behavior.
Yeah. Let me guess. She was in her mid-30s, yoga mom type, blonde hair, long dress, kind of tan.
Not long dress, but everything up to that point was pretty correct. I bet she works for some high-powered people, and she was like buying for other people.
Well, she didn't buy it, so she obviously has no money.
But she had like clipboard, or she had like pads of paper. Like, it looks like she was doing research or something.
Oh.
But she was unhappy.
Mm-hmm.
The type of person who has no control in their real life, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
She probably has a jerk husband that's even more of a jerk than she is. She probably has...
Good, maybe she deserves it.
She probably has jerk bosses who like totally belittle her. And then the second that she's out of both of their reins, she's a dick to everybody.
Yeah. Good, good.
It's like every social worker. Not a dick to everyone, but all their lives are a mess.
Yeah.
Not every... If you're a social worker, thanks.
You're
for
doing
that.
The Lord's
you're
work.
You're doing the Lord's work.
Oh,
but I know... A couple people who were like in that industry where it's like, what? You're a crazy person and your life is a fucking mess and you're supposed to help other people.
Yeah.
But I guess, you know, the people who are being helped by social work are fucking the biggest messes of all.
Pregnant black teen moms.
Well, I don't know why they have to be teens.
Mm-hmm.
Or black.
Oh, Melissa decided, if you've ever listened to the podcast, the previous guest we've had was Melissa Villasenor, and she's here hanging out. She's just kind of...
Just hanging out.
Drinking booze while we're trying to do a podcast.
Yeah, me and Brennan are just doing a podcast. Melissa's here hanging out. Welcome her. Glad she could be here.
Yeah, glad you could be here to hang out.
Thanks.
Melissa's just here hanging
I was very excited when you texted me today and say, hey... You know, we'd love to have you on our podcast again. You're the best, Melissa. And I said, sure.
I don't think that, I mean, you could read it, the text. I don't think that's exactly what I said, but.
You said, oh, you're so hot. We could really use some,
what's
Matt,
the text?
We could really
can I
use
see
some hot babes in here. We could really use a hot babe spirit.
No, you know, that seems, I mean, I did say, would you like to come over today?
Yeah.
I did say that.
Because you needed some housework done, I thought.
I said...
Don't you clean Randy's house?
No, I don't clean Randy's house. I clean my house very well because I was trained very well by my mom and my cleaning lady. I am Mexican.
By your mom and your cleaning lady?
Yeah, they both train.
What kind of cleaning ladies do Mexicans hire?
Good
Mexicans.
Question.
Rich white ladies.
They
that,
hire
that
other
would be
Mexicans?
Nice. That would be smart. We could get one of your people.
I'm not... You know, I took...
You guys are both white.
Yeah, we are both white.
I'm hella Caucasian.
I'm pretty hella Caucasian, too.
I'm like...
But working class, lower... I don't know how I grew up. You know, I never really had a gauge on it until I got out in the world and realized, like, almost all the peers that I wound up hanging out with, like, came from much better-to-do families.
In Philadelphia?
No, once I left Philadelphia and I traveled and
you didn't realize
what I mean
your
it's that we weren't like getting
was.
The well cuz everybody was the same in my neighborhood, you know, it was all cops and firemen and union guys and shit.
Yeah.
But and it's not like we were getting the electricity shut off or like, you know, I don't think we weren't like poor.
Yeah.
But we didn't have like, you know, a big house or
I knew some
servants or manager.
My friend, Melissa is actually here. I was about to talk about her.
Oh,
she was really poor.
Melissa Villaseñor.
Yeah, just hanging out.
Villaseñor Raptor. That's what you called it last time. That was very.
Did
nice.
I say that?
Yeah, that was very nice. It was cool. Man.
Sounds like something. Yeah.
That's crazy. How like I just spit out these gems.
Stuff that means like almost nothing to you, and then Melissa seems to really grab onto it.
Yeah, it gets a plaque made. I heard she's been using some of the things I say off stage. She's been saying on stage.
No, not at all.
She has a reputation.
Because you did do like a few impressions of her. I bet she just said what you said in those impressions, but as herself on
stage.
Hey, everybody, it's me, Melissa Villaseñor Raptor. Oh, look out, I'll spit my venom in your face. By venom, I mean my jokes.
That's good. But yeah, my friend Melissa grew up super poor.
Yeah?
Like legit, like probably the poorest person that I'd ever known.
Really?
I mean, she's not that poor now. I mean, she does, she's a regular at lots of comedy places.
Are you talking about me, Melissa?
Yeah,
that
yeah.
Maybe another Melissa. No, I wasn't very poor, but my parents worked hard, and then we got a sweet house, and then the recession happened, and then we lost a lot of money.
Well, I mean, she told
just
me
recently.
She told me a lot of stuff
in 2008
in confidence, but she grew up like
really
like
no
like patches on the pants. Poor,
no, not at all. Not
like,
at all. No,
like
you're very wrong.
Hopping trains from town to town.
Your whole family would hop trains.
No, nope. Mm-hmm.
Live
no.
on them, like ride the
no.
rails.
Like no. This isn't exactly, but picture. The classic hobo eating one bean
no,
out of a can
with a bindle,
not at all.
With a bindle, dirty, charcoal marks on their faces.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Working in the coal mine.
No, I
gloves.
Think,
oh,
I
did
think,
you have the gloves?
I think you're
with
talking
no
about
fingers?
Your mama's family.
Fingerless gloves.
Fingerless gloves.
Oh, right.
Now, when the whole family is
good.
Riding the rails
you
together,
didn't even hear my wonderful.
This is a serious question.
All right.
No, you said something mean about Randy's mom.
Well, you're saying something mean, making up lies that I was poor.
So if we have a listener that's poor,
no, I wasn't
then they're
saying it,
terrible.
Don't make up lies about my childhood when you don't even know.
But when a whole family rides the rails as one, as a hobo family. Now, does each person have their own bindle on a stick, or does like the dad kind of have a bigger bindle that holds the kids' stuff? Do the kids have to carry their own bindles?
I can't answer that question because I don't know. That wasn't my life.
Well, you probably blocked it all out.
Ah,
of course,
I see you
she
noticed
did.
My
Randy,
cool
they
belt.
Call that you repress those memories. That's a common thing when something traumatic happens.
Mm-hmm.
Like let's say I was legit molested as a kid.
Like legit or the way you really were? Like the way you were molested or like if you were legit?
No, like by the book.
Okay.
The way I was molested was weird.
Okay.
But if I was molested by the book, mm-hmm. you know, like let's say a family friend or an uncle or a teacher or someone at the church or a coach. Or, you know what I mean? That's pretty by the book.
Yeah. That's standard. Standard issue molestation.
And then when I got older, like even like a like 2 years later, they're like, "Were you molested?" And I'd be like, "No."
Yeah.
And I would be. I could pass a lie detector test because I actually believe I wasn't because I repressed that memory.
Right.
But that's not the truth. I was molested not by the book, and I remember every second of it.
Yeah.
But I don't want to talk about it.
Well, and you know the way Randy passed the lie detector test. And this is a tip for anybody who has to take a lie detector test. If you're a listener, you want to be a cop or something, they give you lie detector tests. So a way to pass it, or if you're going to go on Maury Povich, if your wife is making you go on Maury to find out if you're cheating, and you are, and you want to pass the lie detector test, just put a penny under your tongue.
It's true.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Who told you that fact?
I just was like, I was on a website and...
Yeah.
Cool. Good to know.
Yep.
Listen up, listeners. That's what you do.
Should we give Melissa a lie detector test?
We should, yeah.
Do you have it all hooked up?
I can turn it on. Watch these lights, Melissa. There it goes. See that?
I don't see anything.
Oh, it's over here.
So let's. We can ask her some questions, run it through the voice lie detector test, and... We'll hear a bell if it's truthful. Is that how it works? It's a buzzer if it's...
A buzzer and a bell, yeah.
Okay.
And it's all on. It's all through the mic and everything.
This is all a game.
Well, if you're going to treat it like a game, you're gonna come out the loser.
Yeah. It's this software that Randy bought. It's a voice. Right. It tests the stress level in your voice.
Mm-hmm. And do you have a penny? What we can do is we can ask you a bunch of questions, and we can try out the penny thing.
No, because I'm gonna.
If you want to do a test, we can. I'll answer some questions. I have nothing to hide.
Okay.
I guess Randy or.
Oh yeah, we have to ask you a question. Yeah. Well.
Well, have you ever been touched as a child?
Let's start off with things that we know the answer to.
Okay, yeah, right. To test
so,
out.
Brendan, where were you raised? Or should I ask you a yes or no question?
Or just, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Simple.
Did you grow up in Philadelphia?
Yes.
So, I mean, everyone knows that. You've talked about that.
Yep.
Brendan... Did you play in the NBA?
Yes.
So no, he didn't.
I coached the NBA.
Brendan, did you coach in the NBA?
Yes, for one season.
So that's true.
Timberwolves.
Yeah. You ever heard of the Timberwolves, Melissa?
No, I've only heard of Timberlake.
So she has heard of the Timberwolves. Yeah, it's Minnesota. Everyone knows that.
No, I don't know.
Ask me how big my penis is.
Brendan, how big is your penis?
Truthfully?
Truthfully.
Almost 10 inches.
Yeah, you're a big liar.
A little over 10 inches. It works.
Yeah,
it works
it's a charm. Legit. Melissa, let's try this.
Okay, go ahead. I'm ready.
Did you grow up in Los Angeles?
Yes.
Okay. Are you a comedian?
Yes. Oh, jeez.
Okay. Have you ever heard of the Timberwolves?
No.
I don't know. That's a weird
thing. I don't
thing
know
to
what
lie
a
about.
Timberwolf is.
That's a really weird thing to lie about. Back to Brendan. Brendan.
Okay. I only know Lakers all the way, man.
Did you live in Austin, Texas for a while?
Yep. Lived in Austin.
How many women do you think you laid with or made love to while you were in Austin?
In Austin alone? I don't know. I lived there for 10 years, a little more than 10 years. I'm going to say, I don't know, maybe like, how many days? There's 365 days in a year times 10.
One.
So that's 3,000.
Out of here, 650
days.
3,650 days.
So probably about 2,000 women.
So Brendan had sex
with
Melissa.
Yeah, right.
Oh, Melissa. Melissa, did you just fart? Melissa, did you just fart?
No, it's fine.
Oh, God.
What's that smell? What's that smell, then?
Yeah.
What's that smell, Melissa?
It was nothing. It's you need to clean up your apartment.
yes, I do need to clean up my apartment, but what's that smell?
Also, you don't live in an apartment.
Oh, yeah. I live in a house. Ask me some questions.
Maybe you
do you
look
live
more
in an
like
apartment?
No, I live in a house.
Yep. Checks out.
Melissa.
Yes.
How many men have you had sex with in the last year?
Ooh, that's a good one.
I'm going to say 7. Oh, it's true.
7 men?
Yeah.
Think about it.
No, I'm already think I already know. I've counted many times.
Just over the last year?
Yeah.
Like from right
from
now.
January.
No, we're talking that's probably why it said no. From this day back a year.
Oh,
right, from
that
October
more
last
than that.
Year.
How many?
I don't know. Let me count in my head.
14? Uh-huh. Would it be twice?
No,
as much?
No. Maybe like 8 or 9.
Okay. Makes sense.
It's an honest answer.
I know how to have fun.
Uh-oh. Randy.
Yes.
Do you like black people?
Yes. It must be, it's glitchy. Yeah. I think it must be glitchy. Ask me another question.
Okay.
Yeah,
Melissa, you can
ask.
Yeah,
when you were a child, how old were you when... Wait.
How old were you when you were a child?
No. Wait, I'm just trying to think of something. What did you... Did you collect Legos?
I didn't really collect. I had Legos. I didn't collect them.
Yeah.
I wasn't like, did you see my new block? It's yellow. Just got to get 10 more of these, and I got the whole yellow block
set. You know
what
we should do? Since, you know, what do we have? We don't have a ton of time. Maybe we should call our phone sex friend, give her lie detector tests, and have Melissa join in on a three-way phone sex.
Melissa, do you want to have phone sex with us? I mean, with
a
girl.
If you want to hear this voice, giving
you... No, us three are calling a
All
girl.
All three of us are going to call a phone sex lady.
A real girl and have phone sex with her.
That'd be fun.
I think it was, what was it, 1-800-BRENDAN? Or 1-800...
Oh, because Brendan was like the live
party
singles.
Yeah. Randy 69? What was it?
Mommy 69?
Mommy 69.
Wait, what do you mean? A call? Oh, that's what the company's called?
Well, we were just... They probably have a different name, but the numbers also spell that. Is that a fake laugh?
Is that your real laugh?
No, that's a fake one.
Melissa's real laugh.
How do all 14 men that you've had sex with? That's more than a man a month. You have sex with a man. Oh, is it like a period thing?
No,
right after every
no.
period, you bang someone.
No, never. No,
you don't have period sex.
I don't. I'm not fond of it, but I'm not against.
Is that
it.
Where you dress up like a specific time period and have sex?
You're
like an old washbuckler.
Renaissance?
A washbuckler.
Like, what's a washbuckler?
Swashbuckler.
A swashbuckler. Sorry.
I know a guy named Buck Swashler.
Buck Swashler?
Yeah.
Is he a cool guy?
He's a cop. So you fill in the blanks there.
I met him.
Oh, yeah. Officer Buck Swashler. Melissa, you do a lot of drawings, right?
I do.
And you post them on Instagram.
I do.
Do you ever try to sell them?
You know what? I tried and no one bought them, so I said forget it.
Oh, Melissa.
Does that make you sad?
No. I mean, I don't need money.
I seem a little sad.
Yeah, it's sad. It's all right.
I wish people would just buy
if
your
nobody
drawings.
Liked, if nobody liked me, I'd be sad too. Probably.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel the same way. But people do like me, and whenever I have drawings, people buy them. So
yeah, there you go. I sold Randy. I did a painting of Randy. You saw it in the living room, right, Melissa?
Yeah, I saw the painting.
Sold it to Randy for 400 smackers.
Oh,
yeah.
Gosh.
I offered him much more, but Brendan was really generous about it.
It's true. I'm generous.
I offered him 15 grand for it, but he knew that I would, you know, that's a lot of money and that I couldn't afford it really.
But I'm really generous.
Should we try to call 1-800-MOMMY69?
Yeah.
All
right. Oh, I got to get my credit card out.
Ew! You're going to do it?
Guess what? I'm finally legal. Yay!
All right.
I'm fresh, hot,
sounds
super
like my ex-girlfriend.
Tight, and just turned 18, baby. And you know what that means? I'm totally ready to give it up, and not just for anybody. I want you.
Called
oh,
a
yeah,
sex phone
you heard
line before.
Me. You.
You never called a phone sex line before?
No, I never have.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, I swear. I never have. Why
maybe
would I want to listen
you
to
turn the machine. The machine's getting
you,
hot.
Man.
Yeah, let me turn it off for a second.
I want your hands on my tiny waist. Hey there, sexy.
Hi.
We're almost there, baby. Your card has been approved.
Melissa, just play it cool. Don't embarrass us in front of these girls.
Yeah.
I don't want to talk to them.
Hello?
Oh, hey, hi. How's it going?
Pretty good. How's it going with you, sweetie?
Oh, pretty good. My name's Brendan.
Well, hi, Brendan. My name is Sarah.
Oh, hey, Sarah. How are you?
I'm doing good. How are you doing, Brendan?
Super horny.
Are you, baby?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, Brendan, where are you calling from this evening?
Calling from California.
Oh, I love California. It's a great place.
Where are you?
Colorado, Denver.
Oh, yeah, that's nice there, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, me and my...
Where part of California are you from?
Los Angeles. Me and...
Los Angeles, yeah.
Me and my twin brother, Randy, are both super horny over here.
Hey, how's it going? I'm Randy.
Well, we can't have blood relation together. We're not allowed to do that.
Oh, no, me and Randy aren't going to do anything to each other.
I know, but you can't be. I know you guys are super horny, but we can't. You guys are blood related, right?
I mean, Randy's even hornier than I am.
Yeah, man, that's true.
I know, but we can't have two brothers in the same.
Well, there's a technicality. We're twins, but there's a technicality because our birthdays are on two different days. Because I was born at 11:59 p.m. and Randy was born at 12:01 a.m. the next day. So we have two different birthdays.
Yeah, and we're not calling because we like each other. We're calling.
I know, but we're not allowed to do it. That's like taboo call. We're not allowed to do that. We can't talk about sex in the same room with twin brothers that are blood related.
But we're both grown-ups, and we have a girl here, too.
Yeah, our sister is here.
But
yeah,
I
our
know,
sister
but
Melissa's
it's
here.
Company. I can't do it. It's against company policy.
What's the company?
I can't do it.
Melissa, say hi. Maybe you can convince her. Melissa's here, too.
No, I don't want to be a
Tell
part
Tell her how
of this.
Horny we are.
No, they're horny, but they need to stop.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, we're just gonna.
I can't talk to you guys if you guys are blood related. I can't do that. I can't. I'm breaking the rules. I can't do that for you guys. I'm sorry.
But I was just gonna. Okay. Well, what if we go one at a time?
Yeah, I'll plug my ears and everything.
Well, you have to be in separate. You have to be in separate rooms. You can't. Can't be
All right.
In the same room.
Okay. I'll go in the kitchen.
Yeah. Brennan, go in the kitchen.
I have a cordless phone, so I'll
you
go in the kitchen.
You guys are too much.
Can Melissa?
Melissa,
be in the
you
same
go wait
room?
In the living room. Brennan, go to the
Who's
kitchen.
Melissa.
Melissa's
Who's
our sister.
It's our sister.
Yeah.
That's it. She's a sister?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We can't. No, we can't do this.
But
I'm
you
sorry.
Said if we were in different rooms.
What if we're in different rooms?
I know, but she's your sister. I can't do that neither. I'm no blood relation, hon. I can't do this.
But we're all just going to jerk our own gherkins.
Yeah, we're going to listen to you. We'll try not to talk at all. You
no,
just talk.
No, we can't. No, I
that
can't
way.
Do it. You guys are going to have to. I'm sorry. You guys
okay.
are going to have to hang up.
Well,
I'm
what
right
if,
against policy. I can't
okay.
do
so
it.
So do we get charged
okay.
for this?
Yeah, no, she's got to go.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, well, I don't. We don't want to get charged.
Okay, hey, real quick, Sarah. Real quick, Sarah. Real quick, I just have a real quick question. What if we weren't related? What if we were just joking around?
That would be a different. That
okay,
would
then
be
we aren't. We're not. We're not related.
And
we
I
just.
Can't do it.
We're
yeah,
just
we're
friends.
Neighbors.
I can't do it.
We're just neighbors, and we look alike. Me and my twin brother.
No, you already told me you guys are related.
I know, but that was
I
a big goof.
It
was a big
sorry.
Joke, and now we're all laughing about it.
I mean,
it.
This whole industry is based on lies and fantasies.
Yeah,
because so
your
we'll
name's not
be...
Sarah at all. You're probably lying, but I'm not. My friend Brendan is here, and we look similar, and our friend Melissa is here, too.
Why did you guys say you're related? I mean, are you related or
no?
No,
we were just joking.
Yeah, it was just a
we
hot
thought,
fantasy of ours.
Don't be doing that because I can't take a call if you guys are
oh,
doing
we were just
that.
Joking.
I mean,
yeah.
That's against company rules.
It was well, we Randy's fantasy to be my twin brother.
I can't get in trouble for that, sweetheart. You know,
no, we
I
didn't
want to.
We weren't trying.
Me at my job. It puts me at my job.
We weren't trying to get you in
you,
trouble.
Sure, you guys are not related.
We're not related at all.
Yeah.
This is my friend Brendan. And
you just pulled a joke?
It's just
a
joke, but it,
what?
But that's kind of what turns me on is being silly like that, you know?
Yeah.
So I thought it would be
oh,
a silly
okay.
thing.
Well, I've taken you serious because if you were, I couldn't do the
okay,
call.
Okay, no.
No, no, no,
I mean,
no,
because
no,
I can get in trouble for
yeah,
that.
Yeah, no, nobody's getting in trouble for this.
No, we're just...
Right,
we're just
so
looking for a good time.
You guys are not related.
No.
You guys were just
no.
joking.
Yeah,
we're
yeah,
just joking.
We're joking. And our
oh,
friend
okay.
Melissa is she just came over from where she lives in a different place.
She lives in a whole different building.
Oh,
even.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. So what are you wearing,
oh,
Sarah?
Oh, so she's a friend of yours then, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I'm
yeah.
at home. I have on some lingerie, actually.
You just
I'm wearing like a little red and black trim, little lacy boy shorts.
Oh, okay.
And have on a red and black trim, little lacy half top. Yeah, I'm sitting on my couch right now.
Oh, really?
What kind of couch?
Yeah, explain.
Just a regular couch. It's nice and comfortable.
But, like, is it a sectional?
It's not a leather couch or anything. It's nice.
Where'd you get it from?
American Furniture Warehouse.
Ooh.
Oh, okay. But it's a comfortable couch?
It's very comfortable.
That's
soft.
Good to know. As
yeah.
long as you're comfortable, that helps us, you know.
Yeah. No, my brother nice, Randy, soft, he bought the super comfortable couch that we have at our place.
Oh, really?
Yeah, for our birthday.
Oh, when's your birthday, you guys?
Well, mine was actually yesterday, and Brennan's is today.
Well, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was wow. born... Randy was born... 11:59 p.m.
And Brennan was born at 12:01 a.m.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we have different birthdays.
So you have different
so do you
birthdays,
have,
different days?
Do you have a lot of sex?
Oh, yeah, I do. I have a lot of sex.
Our
yeah.
friend Melissa here, do you ever hear the band Hootie and the Blowfish?
Yes, I
remember
have.
That band? Mm-hmm. She has sex with Darius Rucker, the lead singer of that band.
Really?
He's a black guy.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Wow.
She does. She has legit sex with that guy. What ethnicity are you, if you don't mind me asking?
I'm Spanish, French, and Irish.
Oh, okay. I'm Dutch, Irish, Scotch, French,
I'm
and
half,
German.
Actually, I'm half Spanish, and the other half is French and Irish.
Oh, okay. Spanish, like from Spain.
Yeah.
I'm 1/8 Cherokee.
Brennan gets free college and
Ooh,
everything.
Ooh, we got some Indian in you, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, Cherokee.
Mm-hmm.
So
what do you look like? Can I ask you guys what you look like?
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
I kind of look like Randy.
Scruffy beards. They have beards and they're scruffy.
We both have beards, but a lot of people say I look like Pierce Brosnan.
No.
A lot of people say that. I don't see it, but
Jimmy Smits I get a lot.
Pretty good, Jimmy Smits. I get Pierce Brosnan.
They both look like mountain boys.
Mountain boys.
Like they're about to cut off lumber.
That's our friend Melissa. She's a horny.
I like Kevin.
Oh, you know what? We have. Would you be willing to take a lie detector test with us? We just bought a voice.
It's like an
lie
app.
Detector.
Yeah, it's like
How
a lie.
Could I do that?
We don't know if it's real or not, but it says it can sense stuff in voices. It's like an app, you know.
Yeah.
And we've been kind of messing around with it, and so far it's been pretty true.
Yeah, I'll ask you a question.
Really?
Okay. And then you just have to answer truthfully. Sarah.
It picks up by a voice thing or what?
Yeah, just kind of, I guess it senses how
That's
you're
weird.
Answering. Yeah, it is really weird. But so far it's been like 100%.
We tried it and it was right on the money. So your name's Sarah, correct?
Yeah.
Ooh. Well, maybe it's off a little bit.
That's not, so you don't have to tell us your real name, but that must not be your real name.
No, that's my actor's name, actually. Okay. I'm not allowed to give real names on the phone.
Oh, well, there you go. That answers the question.
Okay, so then that solves it.
Are you are you actually super horny right now?
You can build me up to it, baby, yeah.
Oh, so you're not horny right now?
I am. Oh, yeah. What was that?
That means you're telling
was
the truth.
Was that a yes question?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you really wearing what you told us that you were wearing?
Yeah.
What are you wearing?
What are you wearing? Are you fully clothed?
No, I'm not fully clothed. I have, well.
What are you wearing for real?
Are you wearing pants? Are you wearing pants? Who's that in the room?
I'm wearing something, but I'm not like fully clothed.
Is that
or
a boy?
Like that.
Is somebody there with you or is that the television?
I don't even... No, my television's not on. It's on mute, but there's nobody here with me. You hear some voices? Yeah, okay.
Oh, I think it's an echo.
Yeah, it might be my voice echoing or something. Are we on speakerphone?
Mm-hmm. No, I don't have a speakerphone.
Oh.
So what are you wearing then? Be honest, because I guess this thing is picking up on your honesty. What are you really wearing?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I have on like a gown, like...
Like,
I guess you can call it like a gown.
Like a ball gown?
Well,
like a ball gown?
It's like a
Cinderella's
no,
gown.
No, it's not a ball gown. It's just like a.
Like a nightgown?
Something you wear around the house. Like a nightgown.
Oh, it's a muumuu.
Something you wear around the house.
Okay, so you're wearing a nightgown.
All right, well, we should get to some hot sex.
Oh,
if
let's
you're
get
down
to the sex
it.
Stuff, yeah.
You want to do some sex?
All right, okay.
All right, mm-hmm. So, all right, me and. So I guess what, we're sitting on your couch?
Yeah, me and my brother Brendan are sitting on your couch.
And we both have boners.
Okay.
Yeah, we both have boners.
You guys are friends.
Yeah, friends.
I'm sorry.
You guys can't
Listen
be saying brothers or
you
I'm not going to let
yeah.
you.
I mean, you big idiots.
No, you're right. Our sister, our friend Melissa, she's...
Reminded us. Yeah, we're joking around. Sorry about that.
I hope you're friends. I hope you're not lying to me about
No. Well, sometimes Melissa gets on our nerves and we don't think she's our friend, but she's our friend.
Yeah, so we're sitting on either side of you with our boners.
Okay, yeah, we both got big boners. Mm-hmm. And you're
How
been,
big is your boner?
Mine is like 10 inches. All right, it's like 5 inches. 5 inches. Okay. And how big is yours, Brendan?
Mine's it's very thick. and it's average, and it's average thickness, and it's probably like 8 inches.
Yeah, Brendan's bigger than mine. So we're on both sides of you, and you're like, you ever seen like when people go cross country skiing?
Yeah.
And they got like 2 ski poles, and like grab onto our wieners like they're ski poles or something.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Can you do that for us? Should we? Is it okay if our friend Melissa takes her shirt off?
Yeah. What is Melissa, blonde or is she brunette?
I'm a brunette.
Oh, okay.
Boring old brunette.
She's like,
nice. Do you guys want to talk about your boobs to each other?
Oh, yeah, compare boobs and talk
I'm a 34B.
Oh.
How big are your boobs, Sarah?
I'm a 38C.
How big are your boobs, Sarah?
How big are your boobs, Sarah?
Oh, 38Cs. I don't know.
How what do you have real big giant nipples or little tiny nipples?
I have big areolas, a little bit bigger than a silver dollar.
Do you have any babies?
I don't have any babies, no.
Oh. Truthful.
Where'd you get this machine?
So we're
it costs $100.
It was online. So we have our boners out, and you're jerking them like a couple cross-country ski poles. Do you like that?
Yeah. I like that, yeah.
You like it?
You don't like it?
I love it, yes. I like jerking on cops. Right. Yeah.
Well, I'm not feeling it anymore.
Do you want us to... we should probably get off the phone pretty quick. What's the quickest way for both of us to... bang you real quick.
Yeah, we both got a gaz, you know?
Yeah.
Hey,
we want to get our gaz on. You know gaz, like, right?
What's that, actually?
You know gaz.
Like orgaz.
Orgaz.
Orgasm. The way you said it, I didn't know.
Okay, we shortened it. Yeah. Just used the middle.
Yeah, just gazing.
the shortening.
Yeah, but
we got to hurry.
We got to hurry because mom's coming home, so we got to gaz soon.
Yeah, our mother that we all have.
Come on, guys.
All three of our mothers is coming.
Come on, you guys. Stop that. Stop kidding around and saying that.
Oh, no, we're just joking.
No, they're three different ladies. And they're going to be home.
We all three of us. Three of us have different. All three different moms.
All three of us have different moms.
No, we're joking around.
Yeah.
See, look, listen, we're not. Listen, we're not brothers.
Okay.
We're not.
What would that happen? What was that?
All of us are not related.
Yeah, we're not.
Come on.
It's beeping like, are they doing the beeping over there?
What's going on? No,
yes, they are. They're being very dumb.
Melissa.
And I'm trying to be horny, and they're being dumb.
Melissa, put your shirt back on and get out of here.
Put your shirt back on and get out of here. I told mom that we didn't want to see you tonight.
Stop it.
Hey, you guys, stop that.
All right, quick. We need to gas real quick.
Gas
so
real
what
quick.
Do we, do you want to do like Randy... What do you want? Randy's in the butt stuff.
I love butt stuff. Yeah, let me put it in your butt.
Oh, you like butt stuff, huh?
Yeah.
Me too.
Yeah. So, like, I'm going to put my dick in your butt. Cool?
Mm.
Ooh.
You're going to put your dick where, babe?
In your butt.
Oh, yeah. Anal.
In your anal.
Are you going to lick it first or what, baby?
I can't lick my own dick. Oh, you mean your
no,
butt?
No, butthole. Come on. Get with the program.
Yeah. I guess if you asked me to, I would.
It's the best.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm licking your butt, and then now I'm bleh.
So Randy's banging you in the butt, I guess.
Uh-huh, yeah.
And,
yeah.
So what do you want to, do you want to, what do you want to do to me?
Yeah, figure out something to do to Brendan. I feel like a king right now. Help him out.
Well, I can go down on him, actually.
Oh, yeah.
That'd be great.
Yeah.
What color hair do you have?
I'm a brunette.
Oh, great. Just like our friend Melissa.
Just like
I mean,
me.
Our sister. I mean, our friend.
Our friend. And what should Melissa
come on,
do?
You guys.
What
Stop
should Melissa
around
do?
Like that. That's not funny.
What should Melissa be doing funny. Right come now?
What is Melissa doing? She's stuck
yeah, what's she
going to
do?
What?
No,
she
what
can,
should she do to you?
She can, like, grab your honkers, squeeze them.
Yeah, can Melissa grab your honkers?
Yeah. Melissa, you lay down underneath her because I'm standing. doing her in the butt. She's sucking Brennan's dick, and then you just kind of lay up like you're working on the underbelly of an automobile, and you squeeze those honkers.
Could you squeeze her honkers?
Oh, yeah, I can squeeze my honkers, baby.
All right. Mm-hmm. Okay, cool.
So you got all three of us.
Okay, and then let's just like all try to like come at the same time.
Yeah, is it okay if we all gaz at the same time?
Oh, that would be wonderful, yeah.
Okay, so.
All right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
I
guess
Oh, God.
Oh,
God.
Oh.
You are now muted.
Hello? Can you hear us? I think it said we're muted.
Hello?
Oh, it turned off.
Did you just mute us? Hello?
No, she couldn't hear us, but I hung up just now.
Well, we all gazzed, so.
Yeah.
16 minutes, 48 seconds.
that's kind of going to be
that's
expensive
a pricey,
one.
that was a pricey phone call Melissa made us make.
Oh, no. Did you pay with my card?
Did you look at your charge on the last one?
My mom checks my accounts.
No.
You didn't? I wonder if we're getting charged 99 cents a minute or.
It was 89 cents a minute.
It's probably.
It was 89 cents.
I bet it's about a buck a minute.
Oh, $3 a minute.
Well, it said both of them, though.
Yeah, yeah, but the 99 cents, I think, was for something else. That's okay. I was prepared for the, you know. I'm prepared to incur these charges.
Yeah, I got some hard cash. That's funny, because the other girl didn't care that we were brothers.
There were two girls?
No, we called a girl a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, and she didn't care that we were brothers. I think she was making up that whole rule.
But you guys could
company
do
rule.
They, you
there's
could
a chance they
do,
all
you could call and do the group sex. I never knew that. That
there's
was just one on one.
That they all work for a different company and they're just like that smaller company is being fed
most people
into this database.
Most people don't have three like most people don't have a microphone set up where they can all of us talk.
No
them,
one so. Has house phones anymore.
Yeah.
Everyone just calls on their cell phones.
Oh, like we had a three way.
Yeah.
We just had a four-way.
That was awesome.
Oh, that was
that
hot.
Was pretty sick. Way to go play with her honkers,
hot.
Melissa.
Yeah, how were those honkers?
No problem, guys. It was nice.
How was your
you
gas?
Like, you like that she reveals that she's wearing a nightgown? She was called out on her lie?
Yeah, that's a great tool. She totally fell for our fake lie.
She's like, I'm wearing this really sexy thing. Well, this thing says you're lying. All right, I'm wearing a nightgown.
Yeah, yeah.
Totally lied to us.
Man, Sarah's fucking, she fell for it, hook, line, and sinker.
Just took a little bit of confidence on our end.
Oh, man.
I don't believe you really ever have farted before. I think it's just an act.
Nope. I ate beans today. I'm Mexican. I could lay some good ones, trust.
Oh, are Mexicans known for farting?
Well, yeah, I would say so. That wasn't real.
No, it wasn't.
I don't believe it.
Thank you for calling Best Buy in Henderson.
Hey,
Best Buy customers. You can
like
now purchase the products you're looking for with one of our sales assistants right over the phone and have them waiting for you when you arrive. You can even purchase Geek Squad Black Tie protection and services so you won't even have to come to the store,
yeah, I think I like
saving you time and hassle. Thanks again for choosing Best Buy.
For store hours, press 1. For directions, press 2.
So hello, remember.
This is Daniel with Best Buy in Henderson. How can I help you?
Hey, Daniel. I just have a quick question. I bought a voice detector, lie detector that goes by voice from you guys. And I don't know if it's working. I was wondering, is there anybody that I could talk to that might know about how it works?
Well, we actually, I don't believe we sell any sort of lie detector.
Are you sure? I have it hooked up to the phone now.
That's such an easy thing. Let's call another one.
How about you call Electronic Fries?
Electronic Fries? I love that restaurant.
That's what robots eat at Robot McDonald's.
No! No, it's a store like Best Buy.
What's the weirdest thing you ever put in your vagina, Melissa?
Oh, that's a hell of a question.
You know what? I actually, no.
Hairbrush handle?
Nope.
Definitely. I mean, that's just, that's...
a given?
That's putting things in your vagina 101.
Yeah,
that's
Sharpie, the first thing. Chapstick.
Sharpies, chapstick, hairbrush handle. So we'll take, it's, you know what it is? Those three, they're kind of like the letters they give you on Wheel of Fortune. Like R-S-T-L-N-E, they give you those because that's a given.
Thank you for calling Best Buy in Southwest Las Vegas.
What about a roll of pennies?
Customers, in case you didn't know, no. You can purchase your products you're looking for.
For store hours,
action
one.
Figures? Like a Barbie?
No. Nope.
Speak to a sales associate, press 3.
When you're a kid, you ever have like a Ken doll and you put his whole leg in your vagina?
Press 1.
No, but I let Barbie and Ken have their private time.
Same.
Thank you for calling Best Buy on 215 and Rainbow. This is Linda. How can I help you?
Hey, Linda. I bought a lie detector from you guys, and I'm having some trouble with it. I was wondering if you could help me out.
A lie detector?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's the one that you can put on your phone that tests the people's voices to tell if they're lying.
Okay, let me connect you over to... Geek Pharmacy, they can help you, okay?
Okay, how are you doing today, by the way?
I'm good.
Poor little things. Poor little people. They're just trying to do their job, and they're tired at the end of the day, and they're getting all these prank calls.
Hello?
Don't say prank calls, though.
Yeah. Really like having your kid sister around. Ruining everything.
Calling Geek Squad, this is Colin. How can I help you?
Hey, Colin. I'm calling. I bought a lie detector from you guys, and I don't think it's working right.
You bought a what detector?
Lie detector? It's that one that you can put in the on the phone. The voice
okay.
activated
light. What is it not doing for you?
Well, I don't know if I'm getting the right readings from it. I just don't know how to calibrate it or whatever.
Okay, how long ago did you purchase it?
I just bought it this week. I bought it on Thursday last week.
Okay. So what I would probably have you do is come in the store so we could take a look at it. Maybe it was just a dud or something out of the box, so maybe we can exchange it for you. Or hopefully at the counter we can kind of look at it, maybe fix it for you so it does work.
So have you dealt with this before?
No, I've honestly never heard of that before, that piece you purchased, so I have to see it hands-on.
Is there anything, like, because I have it on the phone now. Mm-hmm. What was your name, Colin?
Yes.
Okay, that's right. See, I used it on my girlfriend to see if she was cheating on me, and she insists she's not.
I didn't even know we sold it here. That's crazy.
Yeah, but it's saying that she's lying, but she says that she's not.
Huh. You can try calling 1-800-GEEK-SQUAD. They might be able to support you with that. Maybe kind of walk you through that. I haven't looked at it personally, so I would want you to come in the store so I could take a look at it.
Do you have a...
That's basically...
How long have you been working for Geek Squad there?
Geek Squad, probably about 5 months.
Okay. Do you like it there?
Yeah, I do. I really enjoy my job. That is not... I did not lie.
I don't... You see, that's what I'm saying. It sounds... It doesn't... I don't know if it's... I don't know if it's calibrated. Right,
I don't know, man. That's something you have to come in the store and take a look at. I couldn't tell you that.
Oh, it's true. All right. All right. Well, who's your? Do you like your boss over there?
Come on, man.
I'm just.
Don't put me on blast like this. Yeah, I like my boss.
Is it?
He's giving me a lie detector test over the phone. I don't know.
Is there any employees there that you want to... Any girls who are pretty that you work with? Hello?
I think he hung up.
That would have been a good question.
Yeah.
You know what?
That's like the best crank call idea ever.
That guy is the same guy that we talked to with Mark when Mark was on the episode.
That's the same guy.
I could tell.
You've called Best Buy before with a lie detector?
We got forwarded to Geek Squad. That's the guy that was like, okay, well, I guess if you wanted to look at Randy through his webcam, you'd have to get him. That was that guy.
Wow.
Yeah. I got to remember that number because he's great.
That guy's the best.
Why? Because he plays along a little bit more?
He stayed on the phone for 40 minutes with us one time.
Oh, so you didn't do this to him.
No.
You did, what did you ask?
No, we were talking about.
We had a list of questions.
Yeah, we had a whole bunch of questions.
Oh, that's funny.
And I'd like to send a shout out to Melissa for laughing right into the microphone.
Yeah, during a prank call. The king of prank calls.
I'm not going to tip anyone off there.
Well, no, look. Okay, I can't do prank calls because I feel so bad for the person that I can't get myself to just... can't get a laugh out of someone that's innocent.
That's the best device for prank calls. Like, that guy works for Geek Squad, and you go, do you like your boss? He goes, yeah. Oh, come on, man. He's like, I don't know. They're giving me a lie detector test over here. So I guess he doesn't know what he's talking about.
He's just trying to be a good... He's just trying to be like, well, maybe I don't know what they're talking about, but why would they be calling me if they're not telling the truth? He's just trying to give good customer service.
Do you think the Geek Squad...
But now I got his number and his name, and we're going to call that guy
a lot. Do you think the Geek Squad from Best Buy's all hate the Apple geniuses at Apple? Do you think they want to fight, have a big battle?
Let's call Best Buy and ask them.
Why don't you call Apple and ask them? Apple Genius Bar.
Oh, yeah. We call Apple and ask them questions about their lie detector app that we just bought from the Apple store.
Do you hate the Geek Squad over at Best Buy? Do you want to pound them with your fists? Yeah. Or kick them with your foot?
Jeez, Melissa.
This is cracking herself up over here.
I know how to crack myself up good.
Yeah.
Oh, man. So this is so fun.
If you're in the Los Angeles area and you want to see an unprofessional drunk comedian on stage tonight, just head on down to the Comedy Store.
I'm opening the original room, 9 p.m. Be there.
Comedy Store, also known as the garbage dump of comedy.
Your call may be recorded for quality assurance. I'm an automated system that can handle complete sentences.
Holy shit, so
how can I help you today?
Is your mom, does she have big tits?
I'm sorry you're dissatisfied. Please hold for a specialist.
Oh, no, I was asking about your mom's tits.
Other customer calls.
I wasn't... Why is that a sign of dissatisfaction?
Okay.
You are the next call to be answered.
Oh, tight.
Do you know how to speak Spanish, Melissa?
I do.
Oh, maybe we should do...
No, very little.
It doesn't matter, as long as it sounds like Spanish.
Okay.
Yeah. As long as they don't speak Spanish.
Thank you for calling the Apple Store at Fashion Show Mall. This is Kaywood. How can I help you?
Hey, I just have a few questions. My friend here bought the lie detector app from the Apple Store for the phone.
Okay.
And I don't know if it's... we don't know if it's working properly or how to set it up.
I would go to the App Store, and where you bought that specific third-party app, there would be an app support link.
Okay.
And then they would go over about how to find out to set it up and whatnot, because we're not versed on every single app of like the App Store, so I wouldn't know necessarily how to do it for you.
Okay, well it says that you're answering truthfully. I don't know how long you've been working for Apple.
That's pretty good.
How long have you been working for Apple?
You want me to try a lie?
Sure.
Okay, we don't have any iPhone 5Cs in stock.
Well, that worked.
There you go. Sounds like it's working.
That's. Do you like your boss?
He's all right.
All right.
Hey, there you go. All right, we'll see you guys soon, okay?
Do you work with any cute girls?
Not girls.
How do you feel about the Geek Squad over at Best Buy?
Yeah, they're pretty good.
Yeah, you don't like those.
All right. We'll see you guys soon. Okay.
No, you won't.
Melissa, you haven't been introduced yet.
Do you understand how crank phone calls work?
He doesn't think that that three people are calling him yet.
Oh, I see. I get it now. Brendan,
he's not like, oh, the Bone Zone's calling me. Is Melissa on this week?
I understand it. Do
you understand? You get how phone calls work in a normal everyday society?
Oh no! I was gonna ask the question.
Oh no!
I was gonna ask him if he wants to pound their faces over at King's.
And then he'd be like, "I'm sorry, who's on your phone with
this
you?
Other person?"
You just say it's your hot girlfriend.
Here, Randy, you be me doing a crank phone call, and I'll be Melissa.
Okay. Yeah, I just had a quick question about this app that I got. It's a lie detector app.
That's so good. I like it when you guys do crank phone calls. This is the best.
And,
I hope this guy falls for it hook, line, and sinker.
And I just didn't know if it was working well. I just
Oh, boy. You're the master at phony phone calls, Brendan.
So if you wouldn't mind, I just want to ask you a real serious question.
Sir, is this the best crank phone call you've ever been the victim of?
I'm just going to ask you a quick question
I
about
have to
my...
pee.
Okay, go pee.
I peed a little on the chair.
She peed on the chair.
Oh,
oh boy.
Oh boy.
Some guys are into that. We could start our own phone sex thing with Melissa.
Oh shit, you're right.
We'll just pimp her out over the phone.